In this video, I'm going to show you how to use atmoky trueSpatial when you have a Unity project with multiple mixer groups. So here we have a rather simple scene and we're going to just hit play to see what kind of audio sources we hear. So obviously there are a couple of bees buzzing around some flowers. We hear some birds. To our right there's some sort of magical fire crackling. And on the other side, we hear the babbling of a little creek. When we look at the audio mixer tab, we see that these sounds have been routed to three different mixer groups: environment, bees and fire. Using several mixer groups makes it easy to apply effects like compression or EQs to a group of audio sources, or to simply control their level. For instance, in this game there is a menu where the user can adjust the level of these groups. Currently the spatial blend of all sound sources is set to 3D, but they are not spatialized. That means that sources get louder as we approach them, and we can hear if a sound is coming from the right or the left side, but sounds are not rendered binaurally using HRTFs, so we cannot tell if a source is behind, in front, above or below us. So now let's add atmoky trueSpatial. The first step is to add an instance of the trueSpatial renderer plugin to every mixer group that should receive spatialized audio sources. This is because trueSpatial renders all audio objects connected to the same renderer simultaneously in a single pass, rather than rendering each and every audio source individually, which is much more efficient while still retaining high quality HRTF rendering. To achieve this, each spatializer plugin sends an audio object directly to the designated renderer without using the Unity bus system. So let's right click on the first mixer group and add the renderer plugin to the top. Adding it at the top is important in this case, because we want the output of the renderer to be affected by the group level and all effects that might be applied subsequently. Then, over in the inspector, we have to assign an index to the renderer that uniquely identifies it, in order to be able to assign an audio source to it. The simplest way to do this is by clicking on the Next Available Renderer button. And we will do this also for the bees group. And the fire group. Okay, and now we need to modify the audio sources. Let's find the environment sources and select them all. Then we need to check spatialize and add an atmoky source component, so that we can set the index of the renderer. In this case 1 is already correct, because the index of the renderer in the environment group is also 1. Now we do the same for the B sounds. So again, select all the audio sources, check spatialize and add the atmoky source component. In this case the renderer index is 2. And again for the fire source. Alright, now that should be it. Let's listen to how the scene sounds now. So that's how to set up atmoky trueSpatial for Unity with multiple renderers. Thanks for watching.